Show is hosted by Tony Gaffisone and Christina Jackson. Thanks for tuning in. It's showtime.
Hey, thanks for tuning in. This is Tony Gaffisone live in Redwood City, California. And my pronouns are he, him, his. I'm a Caucasian man wearing glasses with brown hair and a scruffy beard today. I'm in my studio, the headquarters of Brave Maker, and I am in a different space than I normally do. So there's lots of stuff going on, lots of books and movie posters and film gear. And I'm excited to always be with my friend, partner in podcasting, as well as the producer of my next film, Christina Rae Jackson.
Hey, what's going on, Tony? I'm Christina Rae Jackson. My pronouns are he, she, they. I'm queer and I'm an actor and activist out here in the Bay Area. And I'm in my Dublin studio in Dublin, California. And I'm an African-American woman with some wild curly hair today and freckles. And I've got on the Spider-Man costume top. And today's cosplay mashup is Orphan Annie, the original, meets Spider-Man. If you want to check out more of that cosplay, head over to Instagram at Christina Rae Jackson. Hashtag K-Ray cosplay. And I'm in my favorite power chair, the Will Model C, ready to rock out for today's show and talk about movies.
It's a hard knock life for us. Sometimes it is.
It really is.
Oh my gosh. You can find me on the socials at Tony Gaffisone. My website is tonygaff.com. And Christine and I are together. Like, we're the dynamic duo today. There's no trio. Uh-huh. There's no special guest, which is kind of cool. Once in a while, I think it's important for us to just talk with each other, ask questions, do some Q&R, as we say, question and response, and talk about what we're learning, what we're doing, hopefully to inspire you all out there to go after your creative dream. So you get us for the 45 minutes.
Isn't that wonderful?
So let's start. How are you braving your way this week toward your creative goals?
Braving my way with compassion and patience. And I think last week I talked about how I announced a pre-order of my comic and then we retracted that. And now I'm in this beautiful place where I've already reached out to everyone who pre-ordered, and thank you all for your pre-orders. And now we do not have a solid finish line. How about that? And I'm growing more and more comfortable with that. I wanted a solid date. We don't have one. I'm still working with the colorist. And you know, you can't rush these things. Tony, you were just dealing with coloring. So you know the struggle when it's like a skill outside of your skill set. You can't do it. You can't force it. You have to just take a step back, take a beat, and let it be what it is. And just know that your creative project, whatever it is, your film, your comic, it will arrive the exact moment it's supposed to arrive and be delivered. So that's where I'm at. Tony, how are you braving your way this week? Mm-hmm.
I empathize so hard with your story and the flexibility and the kind of holding things tightly and then having to kind of loosen that grip a little bit. The creative process is so collaborative. As much as we try to do everything, which is, I'd say, I'm braving my way this week with doing more than I thought I was going to do. We're trying to, and let's see if you could see it behind me. I think you can. Last Chance Charlene, if you are unable to see, it is the movie poster of our first feature film that has all of our main cast, and it's above my right shoulder here. We're trying to deliver this film to the film festival that has chosen us for our premiere, which goes live on April 1st. You'll hear more about that soon. But we've just been running into some hurdles, and you know, in the post-production process, you're dealing with composers, you're dealing with sound designers, you're dealing with editors, you're dealing with colorists, you're dealing with the director, and all the different people who are trying to bring things together. And everyone hopefully is communicating well and pulling their weight, but sometimes it doesn't go like that, and you have to redirect. So we've kind of had a couple wrenches that were thrown, things that we thought were going to go one way. And so super grateful to the film festival that has extended our asset delivery date, because we weren't able to meet it because things just didn't go as planned. So yeah, braving my way. I would be lying if I said I haven't been very frustrated and sad and disappointed, maybe even shed a tear or two. Felt like I was at the end of my rope, crawling, you know, on broken glass, trying to get finished. But I've had to remind myself, I love this. It's going to work out. That's sort of been my mantra. It'll work out. Had to confront some things, forgive, be forgiven, have hard talks, but we're getting through it. And that is why we do this, to figure out a way, to brave our way, to bring our, you know, our visions to life. So I'm excited to finally see this project out in the world. I've watched it a million times and I want to share it with other people and talk about it.
And it's good. Isn't that so fun and exciting? Daquan shared the trailer with me a while ago. And so I was watching the trailer and sharing with them. And it's like, oh my God, it's so good. Like, Tony, because I wasn't there for most of that. I was on set one day out of what, 22 days of shooting? Like, I forget. So it's exciting for me too. Like, I haven't seen a lot of that. And what I will say about us, and I love your expression, dragging your, what does he say? Crawling through broken glass.
I was like, crawling over broken glass to the finish line of this marathon is what it feels like.
It's a lot of frustration and tears are shed, but it's important that we take a beat to remember we're here to enjoy the journey, not the destination. And it's so easy to start gripping on tight to how we want things to be. And this was supposed to, and then we're not even having a good time and we get to talk about films for a living and make movies.
Yeah,
we definitely have to remember we get to share stories to change the world. So we're extremely fortunate and still enjoying the journey with the tears. It all comes together and it's great.
I love that you said, like, this is like, we're living our dreams. We get to do this really fun thing that also is a job. So there's that really fun and weird and interesting balance of going like, oh my gosh, this is amazing. This is like satisfying everything I've ever wanted to do. And there's money involved and I got to pay people and raise money and meet deadlines and do all this stuff.
Yeah.
So it's all intermingled. But at the end of the day, when I say, oh my gosh, this is so fun. I love it. We made something.
So fun.
I learned something and we're able to say Brave Maker made its first feature film and we already have our second coming up. So
let's more than that.
That's true. We got a lot
coming up and we got almost 10 grand in the account for that second feature. So
let's talk about that.
Let's talk about that.
So, okay.
About that.
Christina and I are embarking on the next feature film called Go Veronica Go. And the script has been written. We have a cast that is forming, which is crazily beautiful. We did a table read and got some really great feedback, and it features Christina's character from Last Chance Charlene. Now, if you see over my shoulder here, this is a picture of Christina. She plays the role of Veronica, who is the manager to Charlene in Last Chance Charlene. And as I was finishing up the film and we were doing, you know, editing in the post-production process, I was thinking, I want to make my next feature film. I have another feature called The Thorns We Live With that has been locked and loaded. We've been trying to get that off the ground, but it has not because it's an expensive film. So I wrote another film in the same vein as Last Chance Charlene that we could probably do for hopefully a same budget, if not a little more. And it's off to the races. So Christina, I said, because it's featuring her character, it's featuring Veronica at the center of the story. I said, I need her to divulge anything and everything about her life so that I could learn and research. And then I also said, not only are you going to be an actor, but I need you to be a producer. Will you accept my invitation? And she joyfully
said,
did.
Hell yeah. Throw some more of those hats my way. Let's get them going. So now, it's wild. It's so wild. And I just to back up, Tony and I met at church and I started as a volunteer. Instead of having a starring role in your second feature film, it's so wild. And getting to learn how to do the financing part, because it's one thing to have a dream. And I know that with any creative project, whether it's a book, a film, an album, when we're actually trying to do all three of those things, they all take financing. And learning how to finance films and being around people like Kayla, who have done magnificent crowdfunding jobs online, That's like the groundwork. Like, have the dream, definitely dream and reach, but then build the fundamental skills of how to ask for money, how to raise money, how to finance a film. And that's what we've been doing and meeting some very interesting people along the way for sure.
So Christina and I have joined this cohort of filmmakers. We meet every Friday. It's intense. It costs money to join this group. By the way, it cost a large amount that both Christina and I couldn't afford. So I just asked if we could get a 2-for-1 and a discount, and they gracefully gave us that. So ask for what you want, right? And we've been meeting with these really high-powered movers and shakers in the film industry, teaching us about financing and going after funds. And we've just been practicing what we're learning. So Christine and I are setting up pitches and talking to people about Go Veronica Go and about the themes in the film, about disability culture, about LGBT inclusion, about what it looks like to address issues of ableism through a drama comedy. And Christina, talk about the without naming names, but talk about the conversation we had this week and how it went, and how just when you're so like laser focused, how things just happen and people who want to rise up to support.
I'll talk about meeting with the gatekeepers, with the decision makers, learning how to do that. It is priceless. If you get an opportunity and you find a credible, legit group to be a part of, it will ignite you, even if you're just watching. And I think we're rarely just watching. We're always, we're in the chat, we're on LinkedIn. I'm actively on LinkedIn, updating my profile. And I think the really important thing that you said is that we are practicing. Like every Friday we meet, immediately after that, I'm already emailing, asking, like it already starts changing your DNA as an entrepreneur. Yep. As a filmmaker, I've noticed that it's already started changing the way that we ask for money. We ask for help. We ask for people to join our team and collaborate with us. And everyone is just building more and more confidence. What else I want to say about that? I met someone really amazing in the group who is helping me put together 100 podcast lists for a comic book tour. So they just bring ideas that you would have never come to on your own. But you get all these really powerful people together who have been doing what you're doing for a long time and a lot more. And you're going to get some really amazing ideas. And the most important thing is to do what Tony said, put it into practice immediately. If you're putting in the time and the energy and the money, because it's an expensive course, put that into practice. This is an education. And that's what I love what we get to do right now. It's like we're in class. Immediately after class, you do the craft. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? If you're a filmmaker or writer, immediately after, you have to reach out, you have to ask, you have to set up. And it's a numbers game, but it works, and it's beautiful.
One thing that has kind of been our DNA at Brave Maker is the doing, you know, the doing. You've got to do. We talk about in our screenwriting class, which our next session starts today at 5 p.m. Pacific time, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard. You could still sign up if you'd like. We talk about characters in movies are revealed by what they do. And sometimes characters, what makes them really interesting and complex and nuanced, is sometimes characters say a lot of stuff and they don't follow up and act on it. In real life, IRL, that's true of us too. We do a lot of talking. We want to make films. We have these dreams, comic books, movies, songs, whatever. But if you don't do it, it's just talk. And the problem, I think, in a creative person's life is we dream. Dreams are great, but you gotta make your own dreams come true. Otherwise, they're just a bunch of ideas. I know way too many filmmakers who talk, but never do. And that's because we censor ourselves. We're afraid to fail. I've been like, since I've been making films, what has worked for me, and everyone's got to find out what works for them, is dates. Putting dates in my calendar, like I will do this then, like May and June, we're trying to film this film in May and June. And if we have to push it, we have to push it, but it's in my calendar. I'm filming a short film tomorrow because I made it, I wrote it, and I said, I'm going to film it here and working with the actors and blah, blah, blah. That's what works for me. But you all, we all got to find out what works for you so that you can get those dreams and go after them and not wait around and feel like your years are passing you by. And that's why this other thing too I love is that we are doing so much networking, connecting, relationship building online, because the world leveled out 2 years ago.
I love that. Almost
2 years ago. We've been doing this show since, you know, the pandemic started. And the amount of connections and partners we have found has been amazing.
I love it.
Do it. Reach out. Ask. Yeah. Make those connections.
Reach out. Ask. You don't have to wait. Send an email. I think there was this feeling before that everything needs to be in person. Email, text, Zoom. It's too informal. But what COVID did was, I think, maybe made people realize the power of you can do this. We can interact through Zoom and achieve something wonderful together. We collaborate when we have our Brave Maker meetings. We're talking to people all over the world, and we come together and we share our wins, and we're achieving things together. People are getting their films made. They're finishing their screenplays. Like, that's happening. And we've never even met. never even met any of these people. And I remember before the pandemic, getting an audition and scampering off to San Francisco and and trying to find parking and doing all that stuff. And it was not. And I remember thinking, like, I really would rather not do this again. It took so much, and my mom is like, I mean, it wasn't awesome. So this is awesome. I know a lot of people don't love these like recorded auditions, but I think you can do it. You can audition, you know, via Zoom or via camera, whatever you want to do. And you're still achieving. So don't let that hold you back. Yeah. Don't let the in-person thing hold you back.
So as Christine and I are chatting today, I see there are a bunch of you watching live. Feel free to throw any comments or questions or things you'd like us to chat about. Happy to do so. I wanted to call out, I connected with a screenwriter group through Twitter. We met on Zoom a couple weeks ago, about 15 of us, and we decided we'll do it every month and we'll share wins and we'll find, you know, encouraging things. And one of the screenwriters from Texas just tweeted me and said, "Hey, I just wrote a short. Can you take a look at it?" And I said, "You know what? This is a really busy week for me because I'm trying to, you know, get Last Chance Charlene finished and delivered." But I said, "Email it to me and I'll do my best to get you some notes. I can't guarantee it'll happen within a day or two, but I'll do it by a week." And I gave myself a week, and it took me about 4 days, and it was really fun. It was a short film, 11 pages. I read it and I typed up a bunch of notes and shot it off, and it was done. It was like, you know, 30-40 minutes of my time. I felt inspired because I was like, oh, here's a guy writing a short film. It was fun. It had a fun twist. So Freddie Robles from Red Rock, where is it? Round Rock, Texas. Thanks for reaching out on Twitter. That was really cool, and I'm glad you did it. I see Daquan, one of our Brave Makers,
hey,
is live.
Hey, that's awesome.
Daquan is going to come on set with us tomorrow and do script supervising and ADing on our short called Blah, Blah, Blah with Jasmine and Marcellus. We're glad to have you tomorrow. But yeah, so let's chat. Let's do some more kind of questions and responding about what we're learning. So, okay. So in regards to Go Veronica Go, you're helping with the fundraising. Mm-hmm. You are the star. You're pretty much in 90% of this film, if not 95. Mm-hmm. Talk to me about what you're learning as you did the table read. You have been working with me, you know, as the writer director. What are some things that are going through your head that are, you know, helpful for other people to hear about the process?
Every part of the process has to be earned, and the fuller that those things are earned, the richer the film's going to be. And that comes from the ground up, from knowing that I helped raise whatever percentage of the funding that I end up helping to raise. That's already changing me as a filmmaker, as an actor, as an activist. So earn all of it. So be a part of all of it if you can. The acting part, earning Veronica, really going back to that time. I'm 20 years post-injury. I joined the disability community in 2002. I was paralyzed snowboarding. And that's when I went through kind of the phase that Veronica is at. That's where we meet her, really confronting, you know, her mortality, her life, and what it's going to look like now as a woman who's using a wheelchair. And so it's interesting to get to go back and create Veronica's character and really think about the layers that go into that and earning that position before she's in front of the camera with Alex and, you know, the rest of the cast, and then earning earning my best friend in the film. Cause you don't just show up on set and you're not going to have that energy. People, you can't sell it. You can't sell it. You haven't earned it. So all of that. So just doing everything the right way, putting in the layers, putting in the time. That's what I'm learning. Like, everything takes your time and attention, and the more love you give it, the better product, a better film we're going to have to share with viewers. And that's become really exciting. And that's made it also fun to really focus on every step of the journey instead of just, oh my God, I can't wait till this is done and it's in festivals and we can share it and you can stream it. Yeah, that's great.
Yeah.
That's down there. But right now, really enjoy the fundraising side.
Yep.
Really enjoy the going, editing the script and doing the table reads and doing karaoke with your co-stars in the film, you know, and doing like live table reads. That was really cool to get to do and have the director there to take directions. And the scene was changing like right before our eyes.
Yeah,
we're filming, we're doing the lines, we're changing it, we're improvising, and it's evolving right before our eyes. The film is very much a living thing, and it needs love and care and time and attention. And the more you give it that, the better product you're going to have. So I'm learning a lot. I'm in a filmmaking school right now.
That's cool. I love that you said that film is a living thing. You're so right. It totally is evolving and changing, and everyone, it's a collaborative sport. We need each other. We need these different voices to do it. I also, just to hear you saying too, your investment level, literally like the investment of your time, your money, your talent is leveling you up so that you are more engaged in the project. And I think I want to talk about that a little bit, because I was, where was I? Oh, I had a meeting today, and one of the guys on the meeting was an actor. He's doing really well. He's on a film in Mississippi right now, and he's been bouncing off to, you know, from film to TV show, and he's doing great. And I was, sharing about the end of Last Chance, Charlene, and sometimes how, you know, you got to wear multiple hats. He's like, oh, he's like, I've only had to wear one hat for such a long time, and it's so nice. And I was like, jealous, you know? I was like, oh. But
how luxurious.
Exactly. And I said, someday. But then I thought, well, just like you said, engage in this moment, because, you know, someday maybe I will just get to do one thing and not have to do all of them, because we'll have a team, we'll have lots of resources. But for now, I'm really grateful for what I'm learning. And it's toughening my skin a little bit. It's helping me figure out like who the right partners are. Cause you know, you gotta, like that phrase, it might be, you know, way too old and passe, but like, you know, the kissing a lot of frogs before you find the right partner kind of thing. It takes time to figure out who the right crew is, right? It takes time to figure out who the people who are most passionate and who believe in the story and also will invest with you. And so I would say too, to anyone who's emerging into the filmmaking industry or has not yet made something, find somebody that you can help and support. If you're an actor, I want to challenge you to do this, but put some money behind someone else's project. If you are a writer who, you know, you got to find a director and a producer, but you also need to pitch in your money too, because it only will make you a better person and you'll be more invested. The challenge I found is so many people are waiting like this. Who's going to feed me? You know, I often feel like a mother bird, like with all these little yapping baby birds they're trying to feed. But so be the mama bird, be the father bird, be the person who also brings the sustenance. And that's going to make you better and more appealing for other people to want to work with you. And you'll bring more value to yourself. And you'll see more projects happen instead of waiting around for someone else to drop something in your lap, right?
And and Tony is practicing what he preaches, because you mentioned earlier that you did take the time with a million things on your plate to go over a script and do the notes and get that back. That's offering. That's giving what you're seeking. So if we're looking for money, we give money. I find ways, small ways to give money and contribute and to serve. Just continue to give what you're seeking, and it'll come back to you for sure. Came back in a huge way Monday for us, Tony, if you want to share 27 minutes in. That giving, that the law of reciprocity worked in our favor so beautifully.
Talk about it. Let's give people some practical like how to's and what happened. Doesn't always happen like this, but this was a great example. We were flying high, that's for sure. Talk about
that. We were flying high. I'll tell the long version. So
yeah, no, don't drop any names though.
I'm not going to drop any names, but beginning with the fundraising process, I was like, well, Tony, never help finance a feature film. Where do I start? And he said, make an email list. Hey, cousin, my cousin just showed up. He said, make an email list. I was like, all right. So I started making an email list of everyone that I thought might be interested in helping us either come on as an executive producer or just help to finance the film, make a contribution. And at the top of the list was someone that we got to work with last year from Ability Path. And I got to shadow Tony as the director, and we shot a commercial for them highlighting their clients. And they had a lot of really amazing clients who have intellectual disabilities, and they were sharing their dream boards, and it was wild. And they were doing all kinds of amazing things that I think the general public just really weren't aware of. So I reached out to the CEO, and he graciously met with us, and he showed up like a boss. I remember Tony saying like, well, what is he doing? Is he like on his phone? Like while he's talking to us, he was literally, as we were pitching him, sending the cash. Like we're asking, he's sending. It was that fast. It was that simple. We were in there for 27 minutes. We made $5,000. So just start, do practical things. I made the email list. I sent the email. We got the meeting. We had a very clear idea of what we were going in. Like what was the mission? What was the ask? And what were we offering? So be very clear about what you're offering, what you're asking for, and why. yep. before you book meetings with powerful people who
that's right.
have very limited time. Know what you're there for, because that's going to build your confidence when you hit it out the park. Mm-hmm. We hit it out the park Monday. It was felt so good. And now we're riding that high onto our yep. next ask. Yeah.
Yep. I want to tag in. So Christina saying be specific. One of the worst things I think sometimes we can do as filmmakers is beat around the bush. Our ambiguity yeah. does not help us, because we're mm-hmm. sometimes embarrassed or too shy or reluctant to ask somebody for money. No, you've got to get used to hearing that word no. And beating around the bush is going to get you more no's. I'll tell you that right now. But if you're really clear, like, hey, we're looking for $300,000 to make this movie. Can you come in at $25,000? Can you bring five people to a Zoom fundraiser who can each give $5,000? Then we'll give you executive producer on our film. Mm-hmm. Can you do that? Very specific. And filmmakers, I know this is tough. It seems like a lot of money, but for some people, this is like $5, like it is to us. Like we pay for a Starbucks latte, it costs us $6 or $7 if you're a venti with a triple shot like me. This is nothing to some people. Find those people mm-hmm. who care about you and care about your project. They gotta like you first. I think this person liked Christina and myself and really liked the project that Christina and I were saying and had a personal connection. And it was like, there's the money. And so mm-hmm. Christina and I both were telling ourselves too, we are going in looking for partners. We're not begging. We're looking for someone who says they want to link arms with us. We're not looking for handouts. We're looking for partnership. Mm-hmm. And we're really clear about what that gets that person in return.
Yeah.
So last thing I'll say about this is avoid saying, could I pick your brain? Or I'm just looking for support. Well, ambiguous. What kind of support? Yeah. What kind of support?
Yeah. Well, I don't know what that is. Yeah.
Support. Christine and I had another pitch for our film festival yesterday with a potential partner. And we went in very specific. We're looking for a presenting partner at this certain level. And she said, yes, we're definitely looking for corporate partnerships or sponsorships, but we also are looking to share our space at this new building we're building. And we have this other idea. Maybe do you need annual support? Yes and yes.
Yeah. That was like an RBI yesterday, Tony, man. Yeah. We had a real, I was texting him while it was happening because I couldn't believe it was happening. It was the Alec Baldwin, ABC. I was like, man, watch him close. That's how you close, man. It was beautiful to watch. Closing is like that's a weakness for me. Like closing is hard because closing is that final wrap it up.
Yeah.
Get that ask in there and get your yes or no. That's it. You're going to get a yes or a no, but ask very clearly and very big what it is that you want. Yeah. And the meeting yesterday, that just, that blew my mind. Yeah. Go big or go home. Ask big and be clear. Yeah.
I often kind of, not often, I always hate getting a no, but I remember I used to look at those no's a little bit differently because I would take it personally. And you can't sometimes avoid that. Sometimes it does feel personal. But when we look at those no's, I find myself feeling proud because at least I asked and I got a no.
Yeah.
Right? A no is better than nothing. So push past that no and get on to your next yes. Someone once told me the answer is always no unless you ask.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. And you get a no and you get to pitch.
Yeah.
And you get to practice. So you got to know, but you got to practice.
Yep.
You know, so there's,
where were we when someone was saying that? Oh, it was last week. It was Lindsay, our filmmaker. She was talking about how she cast an actor years later, like 2 or 3 years, who wasn't right for the first role that the actor came in, but was right for the next project that she did, which was called Seasick. And then to go into Mindy Kaling's the Sex Lives of College Girls. Right? So you just never know. So when it's right, it's right. When it's not, that doesn't mean it just could be a maybe, and it might be right 2 or 3 years from now.
Yeah, I know, and let that be finite here, not now, or not for this opportunity.
Yeah.
And then just leaves it open, and then maybe it doesn't feel so devastating. But the other part that I've had to do in the beginning, you start talking about feeling embarrassed or feeling some kind of reservations about asking. You have to reconcile with all that before. Like, you have to go so hard for your project and be so passionate about it. You have no reservations about asking for someone to partner with you to help bring it to life. There's no more embarrassment. There's no more hesitation. You're going to bring this to life and you're excited to offer people the chance to do that with you. And then it kind of takes out the self, you know, thinking about yourself and how you look and how you feel. And what if they say no, who cares? Because your focus is on getting the project made. That's your priority. Yeah. And then all that other stuff kind of melts away. I'm learning that in the process of asking and pitching. And so, yeah, every time you get to pitch, it's an opportunity regardless of the outcome of that.
Ooh, that's great. Every time you make a pitch, it's an opportunity. And this goes back to what Christina was saying earlier about your lists. So
make those
lists, check them twice like Santa Claus, find out who's naughty and nice. But make a list, go after, and don't just send one email or one text message. You got to keep going until you get the no or the yes. Sometimes I feel as if I'm burdening or bothering someone, but I've told myself if they haven't responded, it means they could just be thinking or they're busy. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times, like one guy who gave recently to Go Veronica Go, he gave a small amount and he said he's going to come to one of our Zoom fundraisers. We're going to do two Zoom fundraisers coming up. And he said he's going to bring some people to it and see how we do it so that maybe he could host one on his own. But I sent him two emails within 6 or 7 days and I didn't hear back from him. So I texted him, hey, sent you an email based on the conversation that we had. He's like, oh, I didn't get it. So just always keep following up. Always get a response and then be really diligent with that list. I'm not the greatest at spreadsheets, but I found a program that works for me where I can keep all of my contacts and I move them into columns and I can see, okay, this person hasn't responded. This person said no, this person, we're waiting on a check or whatever. So be really diligent at that. It takes a lot of organization. Yeah. And sometimes it's a great way to learn the whole business. If you want to be a writer, actor, director, whatever, you also got to learn the line producing, which is dealing with the money and the executive part of the whole thing, the project management.
And embrace
always
it.
Always fun, but embrace it because it's important.
But embrace it. And back to the emails, the follow-up. So those things aren't easy to do. But guess what? There's templates. Like you don't feel like you have to do everything yourself because you don't. There's definitely help. If you don't know, how do I do a follow-up email without it sounding harassing or aggressive? Like, what do I say? I've already contacted this person. I don't want to feel like I'm bothering them. Tony showed us actual emails, like real emails, and he blocked out the names. And he's like, this is how you do a follow-up. This is how you gently, you know, nudge someone and remind someone until you get, like he said, a yes or a no. So there's ways of sending those emails. There's ways of crafting them. In the gatekeeper meetings that we go to on Fridays, they help you do all of that. That's why it's so good to be a part of a community like that. You don't have to sit there and rack your brain. Okay, well, what do I say to this? You could just get a template. You get or ask someone for help who's done it, like Tony or someone else who's been pitching or has been making films. Yeah.
So Christina and I have been trying to get off the ground our own little cohort. We're still working on it. We're saying bye to our live show producer, Alex Todd, who is going into some other work for some time being. And we're welcoming in a new live show producer, Amy Cohen. So you'll be hearing more about Amy in the coming weeks. But we are trying to create a Patreon. That was kind of our goal since January. It's okay. We failed to get it off in January. That's okay. You push back. Okay. You adjust. It's all right. But we want to help more people do this kind of thing. And we also believe we will benefit from it too. Like we want to meet more people who are trying to make projects because Christina and I are producing and maybe we could help you in your project. So be on the lookout for that. Brave Maker is expanding and is growing. And we want to create more opportunities to help you to consult, to help guide you and mentor as we're learning too. We're not the professionals. We are growing. We're investing in ourselves. We would love to help you. So we're also looking for some more people who want to partner with us. It's a volunteer role at this time, but we're looking to find ways to incentivize and increase revenue through Patreon. So if that's something you might be interested in, you can contact me or Christina through our website, through our socials. We're pretty available all the time on socials. I'm Tony at bravemaker.com. She's Christina at bravemaker.com. Hit us up if you have any questions or ideas. We're happy to connect with you. All right. Anything
else? We got
some
save the dates. Yeah, we want to put out our save the dates. Want you guys to put us on your calendar for this summer.
Oh, for which one?
Pull it out. Let's talk about the film festival.
Okay. Yeah. Awesome.
Because we're going to be in person again.
We're going to be in person. Well, okay. First of all, before we talk about the July Film Festival, let's talk about becoming or being BB.
Yes. Let's talk about that because that's next. That's March.
That's coming up. 3 weeks away. Yes. So talk to us about who BB is, and I'll pull up on our website, bravemaker.com. You can find out how to get tickets and meet this amazing queen.
Yes. And then can you show the TikTok reel that I made of Miss BB? She's so wonderful. So BB is the first drag queen to win RuPaul's Drag Race. And oh my gosh, she's absolutely phenomenal. And she's going to be with us with her documentary, Being BB. And what is the date for this? This is like three weeks away,
March 31st.
And then there is a concert after. Can you talk a little bit more about that? Because you're going, I'm going.
So March 31st, Thursday night, there's two screenings of her documentary, and there's also a reception. So you can go to our website, bravemaker.com, and get the ticket. This is put on by 13th Gen, who were so gracious to invite us to partner with them. They're also partnering with the Roxy and Frameline and Oasis and the Rainbow Railroad.
So we're all
promoting this mutually together. So go to bravemaker.com. On the main page is the tickets, March 31st, two different opportunities to see the film with a reception. The following day is a concert. And so if you are familiar with her music, you can check that out and go and do a meet and greet and basically jam out at the Oasis, which I think is where it is. I'm going to put it in the comments right now. So if you're watching live or on the replay, you can go get your tickets right now. Don't sit on this. Don't sleep on it because it's probably going to.
And then you come hang out with us out there, Roxy. And meet BB, and also get on YouTube and follow her channel. Her music videos are on there. It's so wild and wonderful, and it'll be a great way. Or go back and watch season one of RuPaul's Drag Race. I'm definitely considering that. It was such a fun ride. And get familiar with this amazing drag queen, and then come and meet her in person. Yeah. It's going to be so cool. I cannot wait. And Tony, I'll tell you, I'm like pouring over all her amazing drag looks through the years. I think I'm going to get one from RuPaul season one. I'm going to do some kind of cosplay off of her. I don't know what yet, but it'll be huge hair, I know. And it'll That's be amazing. Awesome. It'll be amazing.
We just might have BB on the show eventually too. So BB, if you're listening and watching, you're invited to the show.
You're invited.
We're excited to celebrate you on March 31st. So go to bravemaker.com. The link is there.
March 31st.
Tickets. Yep. All right. Now, also, we are really excited about the film festival. Brave Maker Film Fest coming back in person. You know, we had our first festival in 2019. It was so much fun. We had 40 filmmakers from all over the country come to the event. We shared feature films. We had short film programs. We had pâtés, panel discussions. It was really like a highlight of our just Brave Maker work. And we have right now, we're on Film Freeway. Our regular deadline is coming up. So if you're a filmmaker who has a film that would align with our mission to elevate brave voices for justice, diversity, and inclusion, you are an underrepresented storyteller in some way, you have something specific to say about culture and what is happening in our world and want to have conversations that could change our awareness and make us better people, then we invite you to submit. Go to filmfreeway.com/bravemaker. Film Fest. We are going to be screening our films in the Century 20 theaters in Redwood City, as well as the Fox Theater, which is a huge iconic theater in Redwood City, for our opening night, July 7th, Thursday night. And then four consecutive days and nights of really cool stuff. Christina and I are going to be there. We're going to be hosting panel discussions. There'll be live music, parties, all sorts of people and influencers and celebrities and filmmakers who are telling their stories. If you're watching us live or on the replay, you're seeing the highlight reel from our last event. Alex Ferrari, who runs Indie Film Hustle Network, was with us. He probably will come back. Melanie Victor hosted a panel discussion on film, women in film and TV. It was really, really encouraging. Jenny Gold, an amazing disability activist as well as film producer, was there. So many cool things. We are looking for Film Fest sponsors. So if you are a corporate company or even an individual that wants to put your name on our film fest, you can also talk to Christina and me. We're inviting you to be a part of this. Bring your staffs,
yes,
bring
are.
Your friends, bring your neighborhood. It's gonna be a great time. July 7th
it's gonna be great.
Through the 10th.
And it's such a beautiful, stunning location. The location is gorgeous. So I can't wait to be back in person. Has it been 3 years? We never could have imagined at that point we wouldn't be able to get back together for 3 years. So it's going to be very exciting this July for sure.
Such a fun event. If you are if you're part of the press or you're a social media person that wants to join us, you're invited to come volunteer. We need about 50 volunteers to pull this up. We have a volunteer application on our website at bravemaker.com. We do have a group of interns that come with us in the summer too. If you're a filmmaking student at a school, or you are braving your own way to the filmmaking career, it's a great way to build your resume and get experience in the film industry and schmooze. You just never know.
I started as a volunteer. I totally started as a volunteer.
She's the poster child. You're the Brave Maker.
I was right there. I was looking at those videos. I was like, oh, I was sitting right there out of the camera. I was at the merch table.
That
I was right
wild.
There next to Jenny.
That is wild.
It was wild. And I was over there taking my notes like, okay. Yeah, it's great.
Oh my gosh. You've come a long way, baby. You've come a long way, baby. Oh my gosh. Okay, this is so good. We see, this is what we need to do. Christine and I need to talk more often. Just me and her. We love our guests, don't get me wrong, but we're gonna do more of these. This is what the new show we're trying to create. So help us launch it. All right, cool.
Yeah.
All right. Sure. Well, it's that time of the show.
Brave Faves. TV shows, films, books, songs, technology, clothing, podcast, food, and more. These are a few of our favorite people, places, and things. Brave Faves.
So I watched a powerful documentary last night called Beyond Ed Buck. Definitely watch this. This is a must-see documentary for sure. And it is about crimes against, the LGBTQ community. And it's about white supremacy, and it's about racism, and it's about talking about Black trans women so that we can uplift our stories and save lives. And this story has a lot of layers, but at the very bottom of it is really a focus on what we're missing. And all of this is love. There's just a missing, like, we don't have the love and community and understanding and acceptance and joy that really should be there. And it really starts with us and our inner lives. So watch Beyond Ed Buck. And if you are shook by this film, and shout out to Haley Sahar and Jace Barron. They're the directors of the film. We'd love to have you on. If anyone's listening, knows them, has an email, shoot us an email. We would love to have them on to talk about this amazing film. This is a conversation that needs to be had and continue to be had until Black trans women aren't killed in the streets anymore. And now it's an epidemic that no one is talking about. And it's very terrifying. And there are a lot of horrifying things going on in the world. And we have to continue to talk about all of them until there's change. So that's my brave fave, Beyond Ed Buck. Wow. Available, I think the network is All Black through Amazon Prime.
Okay, Amazon Prime. Awesome. Thank you.
Yes.
My brave fave is Inventing Anna on Netflix. It is this narrative series.
Anna Wintour?
No, Anna Delvey. It's created by Shonda Rhimes, and it's a true story about this scam artist named Anna, who basically swindled millions upon millions of dollars and got private jets and stayed in these lavish hotels for like months at a time under this guise of being a German heiress. It is wild. Wild story. There's another film called The Dropout on Hulu I just watched The Tindler Swindler, but all of these stories of scam artists are coming out, and it's just so fascinating. Mm-hmm. So it makes you mad at how easy sometimes people can take advantage, and that makes me really frustrated, taking advantage of people, because sometimes they take people's credit cards who don't have the thousands of dollars. They're like swindling people who don't have the money. It's so frustrating.
Scammers. I'm going to say that Ed Buck was a scammer because he was able to do what he did by being a con artist. I mean, he was able to murder Black men, more than one, almost three. Wow. before he was finally shut down because of the disguise he was wearing so well.
Wow.
And I don't think he was wearing it very well, but he was able to move and do things in an environment where it should have never happened. Mm-hmm. And I think this story, this film that you're highlighting now, and the other one about the Tindler Swindler, it's like, yep. How are people able to do this? We play a part. As much That's as right. we don't want to acknowledge, scammers can't scam unless we're right. receptive to it in some way. And we have That's to right. dig deep and understand, well, what is it that allows them to move so freely in these spaces and commit such heinous crimes?
What is it
so
about
I think it's
us?
Interesting. Yes, what is it about us as a society, as individuals, that scammers are able to operate at the That's highest, right. at the level that they're able to? How could Ed Buck continue to abduct Black men and murder them? And they're not cause a national crisis. You know what I mean? And it took for a third man to escape for him to finally get shut down. How are scammers able to do that? So it would be fascinating to, ask ourselves those questions. If we're willing to admit, if we've ever been scammed, what part of ourselves was vulnerable to that? What was lacking?
I think what you're surfacing right now is why I love film and TV and stories to do this. They should rile us up, right? That whole thing about, art should comfort the disturbed and disturb the comfortable. I was so disturbed by the fact that these people can do this. And I have been susceptible, not to this level, but you give people the benefit of the doubt. You want to be a trustworthy people. And we want trust to exist in society. But when you see things, you got to call things out.
Yes.
When things seem shady or too good. That's right. Mm-hmm. Call it out, because if you don't, you're allowing this cycle to continue. And so I think that's what I'm taking away from some of this stuff too, is I hope that we're not giving people more ideas to do it to other people, but we're actually getting more knowledge to stop it and prevent other people from falling prey to the scams, So,
definitely. And taking responsibility too, not just watching it as entertainment because you are at the edge of your seat and it is wild. Yeah. But then when it's over and the credits roll, okay, now what am I going to do? Right. There aren't usually specifically calls to action. Call yourself to action. Okay, I just watched that and I feel disturbed. What am I going to do about that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All of our stories are opportunities to take action. Sometimes they just call us to go be quiet, take a bath, relax, laugh, eat a good meal. Other times, like get on the phone, call somebody, reconcile. Other times, protest, whatever. But Inventing Anna, a lot of people don't like it. It seems a little messy and crazy, but I will say I loved the editing style and it made me super inspired. So also a good reason to watch stuff as a filmmaker, because you're going to get ideas, and all good ideas, steal like an artist. We're always borrowing other ideas, styles, right? That's right. Steal like an artist. All right. Well, that's all we all got. Right. Who do we need to thank today, Christina?
We got to thank Carrie Alley, our social media manager out of Michigan, Emerson Morley, our Brave Maker intern, Barnell Amos, our podcast editor, and of course, Alex Todd. You're wonderful, and we're welcoming Amy Cohen, and we're excited to work with you and see those quotes, and this is great. So thank you, Brave Maker team, for helping us do the show. It's wonderful.
We love doing the show. Join us next week for Nicole Levy, right? She is going to be teaching us about pitching our television ideas. So you will not want to miss Nicole as she gives us the ins and outs about pitching and what you need to know if you want to be a television writer. All right. That's all we got. Until that's next good. Time, right? Brave stories change the world.
And you are the story. Bye, everybody.
See you later. If I could find the ending here.
Follow us on Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, and Facebook at BraveMaker.org. Like, subscribe, and share. To become a monthly donor, text the word BraveMaker to 44321 or go to bravemaker.com/donate. Thanks for tuning in.